Hi everyone. So I'm representing India, and I'll be in the next 15 minutes I'll take you to India free of cost and show you very exciting research avenues what we are doing in last one and a half years as a government of India flagship program, which is known as Clean National Mission for a Clean Ganga. Okay, and tomorrow, incidentally, we have election results in India tomorrow. Hopefully this government continues and continue our program. So before I tell you exactly what we are doing with respect to River Ganges is world's third largest river, and also largest river in India. And it spread across 2,500 kilometers right from its origin to its end. And we, as this flagship program, we are mapping entire microbiome through this 2,500 kilometers with 16 different tributaries. And today I'll be discussing one tributary that is at Prayagraj. So before understanding what is this Prayagraj, so this is 2,500 kilometers is the ocean. So today I'll be discussing a small component in this ocean, that is at confluence. Because at global level, confluence microbiome is little understood. Confluence means where two different rivers or tributaries or oceans, they meet, and how one river can influence another through microbial and taxonomic and functional diversity, that we want to see. As River Ganges, it has a very holy importance in India. And as a Kumbh Mela, this is mass gathering which happens every 3 to 5 years, like Ardha Kumbh and complete Kumbh. So millions and billions of people from India, outside India, they come and they mass gathering and mass bathing. So the belief is that if you take bath in Ganga River, and your all sins will be washed off and you straight away ticket to heaven. So that is our belief. And still, despite so much millions and billions of gathering, there is no record of epidemic. So what this river has to do, whether it has some special property that it takes entire dirt and gives you clean, non-putrefying property. So this is what we want to understand, what this River Ganges has. So before that, I want to take you to one video which says what is this mass gathering and other things. Okay. Next 2 minutes. I will also highlight in between where you have to look and what study we have done. This is Prayagraj Kumbh Mela, which was conducted in this year from January to March 2019. More volume, please. This video is not my property, it was downloaded from YouTube. Next, please. Yeah. So my student Rachel, who is mainly involved in this project, she is involved in processing samples for Nanopore, so she has coined this statement. Amidst the land of traditional and religious antiquity exists the heart of Indian civilization, within the beams of modernization that gushes out majestic Ganges. Yeah, so as I mentioned, river Ganges, it originates in Himalaya, and also a lot of rivers originate, and another river is Yamuna. So it's like twin, you know, twin brothers. They separate when they are in childhood and they come again together after 15, 20 years, and one is very good guy and another is very, you know, nasty guy. So these are two rivers. One is Holy Ganges River and another is river is Yamuna, which also originate from the same mother, but it goes through highly polluted and populated locations, and ultimately it becomes dirty and again meets river Ganges at Prayagraj. So we wanted to see whether the Yamuna River, the bad guy, bad brother in among these two brothers, whether it really contributes to this influence is Ganga microbiome. So this same slide. So Ganges, what? So Ganga has it lies between faith and filth, like I mentioned you. As per Indian rituals, it is called as moksha, that if your body goes in the Ganga River, you get you go to heaven. So because of such mythical beliefs and other things, Ganga has been really polluted in last 3-4 decades, and it is alarming situation for this river. But despite this river is still it is a pure river, and in our homes we keep some water from this river as a sacred place, magical thing, thinking that there will be no monsters or your home will be protected. So this is the mythology. So considering this, we wanted to study what are the special properties of this river, entire stretch. So Government of India has given a huge daunting task to study the Ganges microbiome and other effect of other tributaries. So entire project was divided into many parameters. You can see various, so three parameters. One is biological component, chemical component, and health component. So different labs in across CSIR, that is Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, we have 37 labs, along with Indian Institute of Technology, and also Indian Council of Medical Research, who are working in the health aspect of this component. So mainly we looked at physicochemical properties and other properties, biological parameters, metals in the river water, toxicity, flora and fauna, and here it comes metagenomic approach. So as I mentioned, these are our collaborators in this project. So mainly this flagship program is known as Namami Ganga. And as I mentioned, it is a Government of India dream project to understand what are the special properties of this river. Despite so much dirt, still river has retained its non-putrefaction status. So Dr. Khairnar, who is the main coordinator, he is doing isolate culturing of bacteriophages from this river. So at NCL, we are understanding these metagenomes, metavirums, using MinION technology, and also genome sequencing of bacteriophages that have been isolated in this environment. So at AIIMS, All India Institute of Medical Science, New Delhi, these cultured bacteriophages are being used for controlling multi-drug resistant pathogens which are isolated from human clinical samples. And similarly, it is being cross-checked at Indian Institute of Technology, Varanasi. And an interesting aspect of understanding phage metabolomics also is in the place. So today I'm going to discuss only this component. As I mentioned you, what is the importance of Ganges when it comes to India? So we wanted to understand metagenomically the influence of Yamuna River on microbial community and structure and function in the Ganges at this confluence. So you have seen in the video that I was always pointing out at two layers. One is lush blue color water, another was muddy water. So the blue color water is nothing but Ganges, which is flowing from Himalaya to Bay of Bengal, and the dirty water is nothing but Yamuna, which is coming from Delhi to this place. This is also in Indian Hindu, Indian language, it is known as Sangam. Sangam means confluence. Triveni means three. Actually, mythologically, it was known that there are three rivers which are coming together at Prayagraj. One is Ganga, Yamuna, and Saraswati. But the third river, Saraswati, somehow it mythologically it is believed that it was existing, but now it is invisible. Why it is invisible, whether it was existing, that is another story. And how it is influencing to the Ganges microbiome is also another question that we are looking at. So overall, metagenomic component is divided into these parts. So understanding autochthonous community, influence of river, Yamuna River, at the confluence and downstream of confluence, because we, as I mentioned, that despite such dirt, Ganga is still pure. That means whether it has self-putrefying property after a certain distance when there is a confluence, that also we wanted to study. Along with microbial community, we also wanted to study functional diversity, like functional genes in all these samples. So here it is. So our study is pertaining to December 2017 sampling, because we wanted to know before this huge mass gathering which concluded in 2019, what is the status of this river and confluence pre mass gathering. So we, now I will show you later, we also have the data from 2019 mass bathing, that and this we are trying to correlate and see what interesting things we see. So this is a very standard protocol using MinION, as previous speakers have mentioned. Here it is. So what samples we collected, see, this is Yamuna, it is coming here and it is forming confluence, and this is Ganges flowing through Himalaya. Okay, so we collected one sample from the Yamuna before confluence, one in Ganges before confluence, at the confluence and away from the confluence, to see whether Ganges has really overcome the dirt of Yamuna. So these are certain samples, sets. Here you can see everything is almost uniform. So this is bacterial diversity using MinION shotgun sequencing. So here you can see in G15DS, which is at the confluence, here you can see total disturbance. Here you can see uniformity, here also uniform, but this line has some problem, because this is a confluence site which has totally confused, because one river and another river both are coming and microbiota is totally different. Then archaeal diversity, previously it was not reported from this river, so we are reporting for first time. Again, please see this, the confluence sample. Here you can see more or less uniformity, but something has disturbed here. So what is that disturbance? So our physicochemical team is looking at whether it is more of pesticides, metal ions, chemicals, what it is really dumping and making this disturbance in the, or influencing the Ganges microbiome. Then obviously, in epitome we get fungal data also. And again, you see here more of uniform, and in G15, something has been disturbed, but not so drastic like bacteria. So looks like fungal community is somewhat not disturbed, because as we know, fungal systems are very robust for any kind of stress. But very interestingly, it is known that why Ganges has this putrefaction property and why there is no epidemic or endemism when a lot of people come as a mass gathering, is because earlier in 1900, there was one paper from British scientists saying that Ganges has unique bacteriophages. We all know, as a microbiologist, bacteriophages attack bacteria, sort of say pathogens, causing several diseases. So what he has shown, there is some special property like bacteriophages which may be contributing to the self-cleaning of this river. So keeping that in the mind, there were small studies after that, but there is no concrete evidence that yes, bacteriophages are the main drivers of this self-putrefaction. So as I mentioned, our collaborator has already cultured these bacteriophages in the lab against specific host, and these are being tested against MDR pathogens at Medical Institute of Science, Delhi. So we could find, you can again see here, significant, little bit uniform, but whenever it comes to the confluence, something is happening. So it is disturbing, and again it is becoming uniform. So the first time what we see here is reporting various bacteriophages from this Ganges River, and we could find that Myoviridae is major, followed by Hypisviridae, Podoviridae, and Poxviridae. So now we are trying to go in the more details, what are their, how they are interacting with the bacterial host or fungal host or archaeal host, and whether archaea are also contributing to the self-putrefaction, that we are trying to see. As I mentioned, as along with taxonomic diversity, we also looked at functional potentials, and there you can see genes related to amino acid metabolism, biosynthesis of secondary metabolites, carbohydrate degradation, they were more. Now this is G15DS. It is, so it appears that there is a taxonomic, the Yamuna River influences taxonomy, but not functional potential. Also, we could find various genes related to metabolism, genobiotic compounds, that this data we have also published. Again, like functional profiles of using bacterial reeds, this is functional profiles using fungal reeds. So we could find that, yes, it is more or less similar. Now, interestingly, this is this plot indicates, like our speakers talked about a lot of things about antimicrobial resistance or resistome in different systems like wastewater treatment and other. So we also wanted to see whether these also the antibiotic resistome is also is something related to the confluence. So it appears that yes, you can see here G15DS totally falls apart, and you can see here various genes related to efflux pumps and MDR regulators, and they are also appearing in this sample at the confluence. So here is the comparison. Again, we can see here at the functional level, you can see various antibiotic resistance genes have been expressed, and again at G15DS, which is the confluence sample, again you can see here some other ARGs are also appearing. So that we are studying. Again, this is correlation interaction plot using fungal data. Here I mentioned just 2 minutes back that in fungal we could not see any taxonomic difference in taxonomic diversity and also functional, but very interestingly, we do not know the reason why our certain fungal reeds are mapping to Alzheimer's and Huntington's disease, because these are fungal reeds extracted from shotgun data. So it believes that so we are doing some other experiments involving some new collaborators to see whether this Ganges river water itself has some such properties. That's why whether we see this such reeds. So that is something interesting, and this paper is also under review. So what is the conclusion, because I need to catch the time. Present study underscores importance of transient effect of Yamuna river on the taxonomic and functional diversity of Ganga river at the confluence using MinION sequencing, shotgun sequencing. This is the first report of archaea and fungi in this river ecosystem across its confluence. Although the changes affected immediate downstream, a restoration of microbial community and functions were observed away from the confluence. That means this Ganges river has some system which really overcomes whatever pollutants or disturbance is coming through the confluence or tributaries. So what is the reason, whether this has related to some magical properties, like whether this is related to some dissolved oxygen content. Also, we are doing DO studies in 24 hours, like every hour we are sampling water from a particular location to see whether DO increases or decreases. This is very interesting because this is like solving a mystery by using multiple approaches. The bacteriophage profile obtained after this sequencing revealed presence of several phages which were capable of infecting pathogens, bacterial pathogens, and putrefying load of river ganges. Probably this has some role to play. Now what next? As I shown you the video where this mass gathering happens, again this the government came to a new dream that I want to study this impact of this mass gathering on the confluence. So what we have done again, our sister labs and MNIT Allahabad and NCL, we came together and did a lot of sampling at Kumbh Mela, at every bath. In Indian term we call it as a snan, that means bath. Different bathing events, we collected samples from these bathing sites, and upstream of bathing site, downstream of bathing site, at the bathing site. And this, so thanks to Nanopore MinION technology, we could process almost 100 samples within a span of 1 month and generate huge data, and it's under communication. So this is what pre-Kumbh data, what I shown you earlier. This has been published in this August issue, which is ahead of publication in Science of Total Environment. And these are our Government of India flagship, among one of the flagship programs. And NMCG, National Mission for Clean Ganga, is a separate ministry under Ministry of Water Resource, which has established in this government. And our other labs are also involved. Now, along with, so MinION is a workhorse in our lab. So I'll just touch upon few interesting one or two projects where we use this technology. So this is one of the biggest hypersaline lakes in Asia, rather Southeast Asia. So the salinity is almost 15% to 20%, and also hyperalkaline. Alkalinity is somewhere around 11-12. So again, why we study? Because again, so this is probably going to be next, what we say, protected area where people cannot go, because of anthropogenic activities, certain part of lake is in the danger, and we see oil layer on the lake surface. So we have done some sampling, and a lot of data is there. So probably I'll discuss this in next Nanopore meeting or my students. So this is another project we are studying, like one of the speakers said, industrially important biofuel related organisms. So as we know that thermophiles are interesting targets for thermophilic enzymes, which may have application in various biofuels. But here again, our aim was to understand anthropogenic impact on such important ecosystems. So one of my PhD student has done a study from 2015 to 18, where that in 2015 we didn't have MinION, so we relied on Illumina data. And in 2017, when we got MinION, we processed the same samples on MinION to see whether we can save time, because this took almost, since we don't have Illumina system in the lab, it takes a lot of time to send the sample, get the data analyzed. So then we tested whether can we use MinION. So within 7 days we got entire data. 7 days and almost say 7 months or more than that. So this is really fast and rapid. And so far we have published 2 papers related to this work. I don't see it here. This work is funded by CRB. So we are also we have tested this unit in the field itself directly using field sequencing kit, which is recently introduced. So a lot of MinION being used in the lab for understanding microbiomes from unique niches. This is what we do as a culture collection. Mentioned that we do supply industrially important organisms, and we generate a significant amount of bioeconomy through supply of industrially important cultures throughout India, and also provide certain services related to identification. So this is my Nanopore team, and this entire project was right from sample collection. She was involved in the sample collection. Rachel is the student. She has in fact standardized all the protocols with the help of Nanopore community and support Nanopore tech team. And so the new student Rakesh is also working on river ecology aspects, because in India almost 70-80% rivers are dead. So we are trying to see what are the reasons and how these communities, microbial communities, are getting affected because of pollutants. And Kushal is the student work understanding human microbiome, rather more specifically transcriptome in different stress conditions. So that is also, so lot of MinION going on, lot of omics going on in the laboratory. So finally, last slide. So I thank Council of Scientific and Industrial Research for supporting the study, and Academy of Scientific and Innovative Research for fellowship, and Ministry of Water Resource, our funding backbone, who has generously funded this study for last 2 years, and it's going on. So this is our team working on these different aspects. So here, before concluding, I want to show you something. We can see only humans here and only birds here. So this is nothing but Ganges, and this is nothing but Yamuna, which is sort of contaminated. You can see here birds always prefer clean site. This itself is an indirect indication that they won't cross this, but we may cross here. Thank you.